Hello, this is Ms. Barnacle again. Right now we're going to talk about square roots. Okay, when we talk about square roots, we talk about operations. Let's talk about opposite operations. First, you have addition and subtraction. Those are opposite operations. You have multiplication. And now we're going to learn a new one, and the new one is square roots and what they say, squaring a number, which means a number times itself. So when we talk about operations, remember, add, subtract, multiply, divide, those are the basic four. But then you have squaring and square roots, that's another operation and it's opposite. So that's what we're gonna work on today. This section, when we talk about taking the square root of a number, you have seen this little sign that looks like a little check with a stick at the end of it, and that is your square root sign. It's called a radical sign. It is not a division sign. Division signs are not made into an actual check. So when you talk about square root, square roots are numbers that are multiplied to themselves to give you an answer, okay? So I'm going to go to the board and we're going to do a few of these as examples. Okay, so when we have this, we have 6 squared. So 6 squared means 6 times 6, which is 36. And the opposite of 6 squared would be the square root of 36. So when you say the square root of 36, that means what number multiplied to itself will give you 36? And that would be 6 times 6 gives me that 36. So the square root of 36 is 6. And the same token over here, we have 3 squared. 3 squared is 3 times 3. That's what that means. And our end result is 9. 9 is my perfect square. So the opposite of that would be the square root of 9. So the square root of 9 means 3 times 3. What times itself will give me that 9? And that is 3. So the square root of 9 is 3. Okay, there are a couple of other ones that I want to do just as examples for you. Let me erase this. And if you know your perfect squares, if you know your multiplication tables, if I wanted to know what the square root of 1 is, you would say, what times itself gives me 1? 1. Okay? If I wanted to know what's the square root of 25, that means what multiplied to itself gives me that, and that would be 5. What's the square root of 64? 64 would be 8 times 8. Okay, and this goes on forever and ever. So if I wanted the square root of 144, that would be 12. Okay? All right, so we are done with that section. Our last section deals with the order of operations when we put all of the multiplication, addition, subtraction, exponents, parentheses, we put all of that together and we do, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. So that is going to be the next topic that we talk about.